Hello everyone, Alex is here. Many of you ask Ailey to ask me to give you a roadmap or a learning path how to become a backend engineer. This subject itself is very complex if you compare it with the front end. In the front end, you still have to deal with lots of libraries, it's true, and the complexity associated with that, but in the end, you deal with only three things, right? It's JavaScript, HTML, and CSS. Three. If you contrast that with the backend, you will see that we have a plethora of languages and even more different frameworks and libraries that you have to use with each of the languages. Then you also need to learn and understand a lot of complex concepts that come along with the designing systems that runs on the backend or on the server side. You guys asked this question a while ago, but I was struggling how to nicely present this to you. Ellie and I did some brainstorming recently to understand how can we present you and give you a clear picture of what is the learning area that you need to familiarize yourself to be a good backend engineer. And lately, I did a lot of job interviews for a senior backend engineer in our team, and it gave me opportunity to look and understand and analyze and think about what are the qualities that our team is looking at in the candidates that are applying to the job of a senior backend engineer in our team. Also, I changed my job recently, which means I spent a couple of months thoroughly researching the job market, looking at different companies, what they are looking for in the backend engineers, studying a bit and going through three job interviews with the three different companies.
And you passed all?
Yes, I passed all three technical interviews, and eventually I picked the offer that suits me the best, and that's it. What? And that's it. See you guys. Also, I changed my job recently, which means I spent a couple of months researching the market, and now I have a good understanding of what the companies at the moment in the market are looking for in the candidates who apply for the backend job positions. And we took this recent experience of mine and understanding of the market to sit with Ellie and sketch out a nice picture that represents what sort of knowledge and learning have to happen for one to become a good backend engineer. Without further ado, I'm announcing that we're kicking off a series of videos, and in the end of that series, you will get a clear roadmap of how to become a good backend engineer. Looking at the job market, I found that backend jobs, generally speaking, falling into two categories. Companies that look for a specific language or framework specialist, someone who can get the job done, kind of a language and framework ninja, who understands deeply all the intricacies of a language or the framework and the comfortable writing code and features in that domain. It also correlates with the goal of some of you who express that they want to learn just enough of a backend to be able to complete development of the web application on your own. Say you know some of the frontend already, or if you don't, make sure you check out some of the Ellie's videos, maybe somewhere here and there, and her online courses. And then you probably want to know just a little bit more of a backend side to be able to understand how you host your backend side, how do you write your server side code, and complete the whole application on your own. Say, a shopping mall. And the second category is the company is looking for a candidate with a good breadth of knowledge around the concepts associated with the systems design for the cloud and the server side. A sort of a systems design guru who knows about scalability, reliability, and have a hands-on experience on one or more cloud platforms. So let's have a closer look at these two categories and understand what they consist of. And let's start with the tool. Python.
Django.
Ruby.
Rails.
Node.
Express.
PHP.
Laravel.
C#. Java. Go. And you got the picture. As you can see, it's a lot, and it's overkill to learn everything.
Yes, it is really important you do the job research first to see what is the most popular language and frameworks in your country.
That's right. So you pick one, you master it, and you stick to it.
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 So Alex, after that, what should I do?
Well, tools are just tools. Like, if you want to build a house, is it enough to have a hammer and to know how to nail a nail?
No.
That's right. This is not enough. If you think of the simplest of the backend applications, what is it? It's some sort of an application running somewhere in the cloud or in the server side, accessible via network. And normally what it does is manages the state. It stores it somewhere in some kind of a database and provides an access to it to the front end via some sort of an API. So what it tells us? It tells us that you need to have an understanding of how to work with the database, or how to pick a right database for you, because what we know, we have an SQL databases or NoSQL databases. You also need to understand how to design and implement the APIs. And again, we have a choice, right? We have different types of APIs that you can provide. You can provide a REST APIs, you can provide GraphQL or gRPC as an example. So to be a good backend engineer, even in the smallest scale, you need to have not only the knowledge of the tools, frameworks, you need to have a knowledge of those concepts related to database design, API design, and on top of that, you need to secure your backend. So you need to understand the security concepts like authentication and encryption. If you look at the concepts area, it's also large, and you don't have to learn everything from the get-go. There is a path to it, and you will learn many of them by doing actual work. But there are certain concepts that are more important than others, and you need to learn them first before you proceed and study other concepts. I just wanted to give you a brief overview of what you're up to if you step on the path of the backend engineer.
So guys, if you recall my video about the T-structure of learning, this is also applicable here.
You start with the language and the framework that let you get the job done. You master it until you become a code ninja. You study the fundamental concepts like API design, databases, and basic security. And from there, if it aligns with your career path, you expand your knowledge to advanced concepts of system design and enter the world of senior backend engineers.
Here we go. In this video, we try to give you a high-level overview of backend engineering journey. I know it can be overwhelming. How do you feel? Please leave the comments down below how you feel about it. You don't need to know everything up front, so...
That's right. We will prepare a few more videos and we will touch on every topic in more details. And by the end of the series, you will have a clearer picture and a clearer roadmap of studying to becoming a good backend engineer.
So please like this video if you want to get more videos like this, and please let us know what you want to study more or understand better. So we will see you in the next video. Thank you so much, and don't forget to code your
dream.
Bye.